Hi, I'm Annika Lees, a lead reviewer at the CAGBC. Today's reviewer insight video is to show you how our lead reviewers confirm compliance for the BPDO credit material ingredients. For this presentation, we will look at the most common documentation submitted and what we look for in it so that you can check your projects before submitting. I'm focusing this presentation on V4.1, as most projects are substituting with the V4.1 credit. Option 1 is typically achieved with health product declarations, known as HPDs, cradle-to-cradle certificates, and declare labels, so that is what we'll focus on. HPDs are either basic or nested. Let's start with a basic HPD. But note that nested HPDs only require one additional thing. We're going to walk through these six requirements in the next slides. For a basic HPD, make sure that the product name and manufacturer are right for the product and align with the naming convention you used in the calculator. Then check to make sure that it is 100 or 1,000 parts per million. The other options here are not acceptable. Make sure that it is both characterized and screened. Some versions also have a Yes EX option. This is okay, they just cannot be marked No. At the bottom of the first page, you can tell if it's third-party verified, which is worth 1.5 products. Here, you'll also check that the date is applicable to the project timeline. Finally, scroll to the end of the HPD and ensure that the contact information is complete. For a nested HPD, you have one additional thing to check. Scroll through the entire HPD while looking at the left side. You are looking for any ingredient content ranges over 20%. For these, there must be a reason for that range for the HPD to be accepted. Cradle to cradle is quite simple. Make sure that the certificate is version 3 and at least a bronze level. Remember that cradle to cradle is third-party verified, so select that in the building product calculator. It's worth 1.5 products. And don't forget to check that the date is applicable to the project timeline. Declare labels that are red list free and declared are accepted. But labels that are LBC compliant, now called LBC Red List Approved, must indicate on the label that they have content inventory to 0.1%. This will be shown on newer labels as 99.9% at 100 parts per million. LBC compliant labels, or LBC Red List Approved labels, have proprietary ingredients. These cannot exceed 0.1% to comply for material ingredients. This label has less than 0.1% undisclosed ingredients, and therefore it is compliant. Make sure to check the ingredients list and add up all undisclosed ingredients. This LBC Red List Approved label has 0.07% and 0.24% undisclosed ingredients. This exceeds the 0.1% allowance, and therefore it is not compliant for material ingredients. Only the declare labels that have the added logo on them are third-party verified. When filling in the building product calculator for option 1, ensure that you've used a clear naming convention for products and that the supporting documents are named clearly in alignment. Next, make sure that you are picking the correct type of reporting and noting if it is third-party verified. Option 2 can be a bit more intimidating, yet it is most frequently and easily pursued using declare labels and cradle-to-cradle certificates. The table in the V4.1 beta guide is quite important in navigating this option and will need to be closely followed when assembling your documentation and completing the calculator with the correct selections. For this video, we will limit our attention to what we are seeing most often in review. For declare labels to be accepted for advanced inventory and assessment worth one product, they must be designated Red List Free or LBC Red List Free and include the third-party verified logo. Cradle to cradle again is quite simple. Just make sure that the certificate is version 3 and that the date aligns with the project timeline. If the certificate is bronze, it qualifies as advanced inventory and assessment worth 1 product. If silver, it qualifies as material ingredient optimization worth 1.5 products. When filling in the building product calculator for option 2, refer back to the table in the beta guide to determine the certification program for your document. For option 2, you only need 5 products from 3 manufacturers. Using a combination of cradle to cradle and declare will get you there quickly, and these documents are out there for common materials used on lead projects. I was only able to cover the most common submittal material today. But for compliance checklists and more submittal tips, please check out the USGBC's Product Compliance Checklists, which the USGBC published in 2022. The guidance is for manufacturers and project teams using the LEED V4.1 credits, environmental product declarations, sourcing of raw materials, and material ingredients. Another great resource are the detailed graphics on the Health Product Declaration Collaborative website. There you will find graphic presentations of the various HPDs and what you need to meet the requirements of options 1 and 2. We hope this provided some helpful information. Thank you for listening.